Hello, everybody. Back here at Preseason Game 3, and forgive me, my throat is hurting a bit, so it's going to be kind of tough for me to talk. And I need to turn my air conditioner off. Whoops. Alright, here we go. Let's go to improve our team. Let's see here. What do we need to do? Oh, yeah, we don't need a quarterback. Probably could use a backup quarterback. Alright. Let's see what we need to do here. Panthers tend to zone blitz. We should focus on levels drill to counter. Alright, levels. Where's freaking level? There it is. Okay. We'll probably see a lot of read option. The inside run, okay. Alright, so who should we work on? It's actually... Let's work on Akeem Ayers here. Okay. Yeah, let's do that. And we'll just go ahead and simulate. All right. All right, let's start the game up. Really should. Dang it, I should do that. What is it? That quick game thing? Because I kind of wanted to get through this kind of quickly. Since school starts, I'm running out of time. Like, what the freak? When the music stops, I'll turn the audio back on. Of course, stupid YouTube just has to do their stupid crap. Give me copyright. Alright, I'll turn it back on. NFL on EA Sports. It's hard to imagine this not being a game to watch. It's the Patriots going up against the Panthers. Alright, let's get this thing started. No one cares about preseason anyways. Charlotte. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis. They were the final two unbeatens in the NFL a season ago. The Pats and Panthers are underway. This is taken. All right, here we go. Had a good return. He's across the 35. Darn it, they're getting the ball first. I'm not going to get my first stringers to get in there. Darn it. Okay. All right. Let's get him.
Now it's the Princeton man. This is Spencer Ware. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line.
Not too bad of a stop there.
So the offense looking at a second and eight. They run again.
Oh, got stuffed, son.
Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive. 45, 45. throwing on third down. Stafford, he's got time.
Come on, get him! Whew, that was close.
At the 44. It's a gain of 9 yards.
All right. Now the part that I've been struggling with, offense.
The veteran left-footed punter Donnie Jones to kick it away. Back deep, Travis Benjamin.
Whew, that's way back there.
And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback.
All right.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. This is and he'll find some space.
All right, pretty decent run.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. On second down, it's
McCoy. Oh! Dang it! I thought I was freaking out of there.
Scrimmage and no more. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
But when it comes to the running game, the New England Patriots, they're one of the few teams in the NFL that I don't think care much about balancing things out.
Last year, to your point, fifth in passing yardage, number 30 in the run game.
Boom! Right to them, baby.
Not so much their own personnel, and they try to attack that way.
Isn't it weird seeing Drew Brees throwing the Gronk?
These intermediate passing plays, and it paid off there.
And they took that focus not just to the practice field, but in the film room to show the guys exactly what they wanted, what types of looks they should expect to get.
Those coverages each and every always off screen, man. Always.
Solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves them with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
On second down, here's Breeze.
Nice.
That's well done. Able to drag the feet, he's going to have the first down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs. In this case, feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. The first carry here for Jaquizz Rodgers.
Nice.
It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gain, they can run that play on any down.
Breeze now on first down. And nearly.
Dang it.
Off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Breeze will try again on second down.
Boom.
And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. A good pickup there, a 22.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come up and put a hit on him, do they?
He was trying to get it to LeSean McCoy.
I didn't get it.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that
play.
Incomplete. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaughton, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number 2. They're in the midst of a nice drive, but facing a 3rd and long here. First chance for the backup here to throw.
Nice.
The 6. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. And now the passing game here in the second quarter is starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now.
Dang it.
Starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Not able to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Now Clemens. That's caught at the three.
There we go.
Take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Ryan Hewitt from 3 yards out, and the Patriots have taken the lead. And he wasn't blocking or running it there. They tossed it to him.
And you remember the good old days when the 49ers were riding roughshod in the league? They use their fullback in pass plays all the time. Roger Craig.
All right, here we go. It's going to be boom.
Running these types of plays.
Look at that.
And that'll carry over the back line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went
and
three
now
and out.
Have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'm trying to do better here. Again, a run with Thompson. And running room.
There we go. Nowhere, son.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
There's another example of why they haven't scored any points so far. I think it's time to abandon the run game, spread things out, and go to the air. It certainly can't be any worse than what they've done so far.
They'll run it now, out of the gun.
Yeah, nice tackle.
Line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain that time, but it leaves him with 3rd and 11 coming up. He makes a wonderful play there off the corner, protecting his side of the field.
Oh, that reminds me of the great defenses of old, doesn't it? The Pittsburgh Steelers, Steel Curtain, they would not let you get on the field if you could only do one thing. You had to be a complete guy, and you had to be able to tackle.
Now, I know I've said this
before. Oh, you didn't. What the heck? There's a guy right there. He could have had him.
I'm going to keep peppering that in there, and one of these days, you're going to think that you were. And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up.
Come on, get him.
These guys used to be basketball players. Somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism.
Oh, my God. I keep doing that.
Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
They'll run with Thompson.
Got him.
And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
They'll look to
nice. There we go.
Complete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds.
All right.
And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back.
Oh! Dang it.
By Nickel Roby. And they have the football that will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying a ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
from the shotgun. He'll look to
throw. Ooh, almost intercepted.
Miles Austin, the intended receiver. And just like that, it's third down.
I think that's a big time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he's able to bat it away.
So the offense, a little antsy, the flag comes out.
Nice, there we go. Yard penalty.
False start, offense.
So they've been unable to capitalize on a great field position as of yet. Here's third and nine.
Here we go. White 90.
On third down, he'll drop to throw.
There we go.
Just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball,
see if we can get a block here.
Make it tough. That's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And Nugent puts it through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So after the pick, they can't capitalize for six, but they do get three.
And I know in this situation, most of us want to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit. Taking over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
Ah!
I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. There's Clemens.
Oh, come on, man.
It's incomplete.
Really need a new backup.
Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third.
All right, here we go. Green, 39.
Looking to throw. They'll roll him out right.
Nice. What? Oh my god, that's freaking garbage.
Easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have. And a pass he should have caught.
And that'll hit at the five and go into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Come on.
And he's brought down. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Darn it.
Come on, let's go. White.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. On the left side, a catch by White. Calling a pickup of seven, and it's a second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to
throw. Oh!
And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half. 3 yards left to grab here on third down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Ah!
And that is
darn it.
Incomplete. Here's Donnie Jones now, as he's on to punt for Carolina. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And a nice job here on special teams. This will be down inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. Now the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point...
Well, not very many highlights again.
Where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. Both the Panthers and the Patriots are not doing much on the ground, and it's easy to see why that would play into this low-scoring game. We'll have to see if either team gets it going on the ground in the second half. All right, let's do it. Here's a look at the first half highlights. Continuing on the drive, coverage breaks down here. And this play goes for a score as they put the first points on the board.
All right, Larry, thank you. A fairly
tight game
here.
Yeah, not very many.
Play in this second half. Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. On the ground, Rodgers.
Yeah.
Yards on the pickup, and it gives the Pats a first down.
Well, that's the desired outcome coming out here in the second half, of being able to run the football and establish a little bit of pace and maybe even a bit of dominance at the line of scrimmage. They want that to continue. Way too early to this being ball control time. But the way they're running it, you got to think they may want to continue that and see if they can go ahead and grind their opponents into submission.
The defense won that play so fast, and I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
They'll run it here. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough third and 12.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
Trying to figure out. I guess I'm running this.
Throughout the game, and with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
Darn it! I can't... Oh, my God.
Only the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10.
Come on, let's go! Right,
they'll run it now out of the gun. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Finding time.
There we go. Boom.
Escape and he goes down. They push him back 8 yards that time on 2nd down. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you get 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
And he drops this off to Thompson, complete.
All right. That was a short drive.
That'll bring up 4th down. Here's Donnie Jones now. And he's on to punt for the 4th time tonight.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it?
Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Sorry about that, guys.
He juked him. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And the Patriots take over. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively.
Here we go now. All right. Yes.
Give him 11 on the gain there, and it'll give the Patriots a first down.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. You've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Second down, 8.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes day in play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. But at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Now back to throw. And he's got his man, Denell.
There we go.
He's brought down after a good game. They convert on third with a gain of 22. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
They'll run. It's
Ryan.
Taken down after a minimal pickup, and that will take us to the end. And we're back now in Charlotte. We get set for the fourth quarter. Patriots have the lead. They also have the football. Clemens. He's got a man. It's Williams. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark, because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or a takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Darn it.
Bryce Butler, the intended receiver. And that'll make it second and 10. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
So third and inches, and this will be the ninth play of the drive. Now Rodgers. And he's got the first down.
Nice.
He gets it to the 8. They give him 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Another carry now. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. And this seemingly endless drive continues. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
It's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult. Skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him
Darn it.
Defense, you're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You were able to keep him within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
After knocking through the field goal, here's Gano back out there now for the kickoff. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And making their way back out there now, the Patriots defense. They got the stop last time that resulted in a punt, and then it resulted in three for their offense.
And this is one time where the defense won't get credit for creating points, but that's exactly what they did. All right, forced them into a punt, turned it over to their
nowhere to.
There we go.
He goes down. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack. And leading here late, so a chance for the defense to really close out this game if they can halt the offense. He came in off the edge so quickly there.
Oh, that's exactly what it was. Someone scooped up.
It's alignment to his quarterback because he had no chance to block it.
So this offense really needs to make something happen here late in the fourth with the football.
An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers.
Picked off, baby.
There as it's intercepted. Picked off by Antonio Cromartie. And this one will be brought back to the 22.
Brandon, offensively, this has been a tough day for him. Trying to find a place to throw the football, it's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who've had the receivers on lockdown.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. Time for a break. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. A handoff as they run the counter play. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this third and eight. Penalty marker is down here.
Darn it.
They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Rookie Deion Jones picked it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So the dang it, man.
The defense, the holding.
Oh, that was defense. Okay.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Here we go. Green. That one looks like he'll throw here. He hits Rodgers in the flat. And he's going to be brought. The Panthers are going to take another timeout. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Dang it.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
There we go.
And he is in. Touchdown, New England. Jaquizz Rodgers, his second touchdown on the season. And the Pats take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Carolina getting set to take the field. And following the interception.
All right, here we go. Interception. Are you a little bit more stop him.
When you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out here the window.
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice
and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. It'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack. And it's third down. On third down, he'll drop to throw.
Picked off. Cromartie.
By Antonio Cromartie. That he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
Antonio Cromartie is no different than the rest of us. He dreams of making the big play at the end of the game and sealing a victory for his team.
Well, the difference is here, you used to do it. He just did it and has done it before. I've never done it.
I didn't do it either, but I dreamed the same way. Congratulations to him. He just finished that game off with an interception.
Oh, boy.
As it comes inside the 42nd mark, and that should be enough to put this one on ice.
All righty. This game is over.
Charles, so you win the game. Not only do you get the W in the left.
Okay, let's see how my players did. Yeah, I cannot do well with Clemens. Okay.